class. Good afternoon, everyone. So the class for today is on the topic placentation. We have read about physiology of pregnancy. So placentation is one very important topic, or you can say placentation is one very important process which needs to be there for carrying out the successful pregnancy. So what is a placenta? First of all, we should know what is a placenta. Placenta is nothing, but it is an apposition. Apposition means when two different layers come in close contact with each other, it is called apposition, or fusion of the fetal membranes with the endometrium of the uterus, which will permit a physiological exchange between fetus and the mother. This physiological exchange includes for both this gaseous exchange as well as nutrient exchange. And the third exchange will be for the waste products, because fetal body will be producing some waste products which need to be drained out of the fetal body. So there is no way else to drain this this waste out but the female body only, or the mother's body or dam's body, whatever you call it. So this placenta originates from various fetal membranes, and there are feto-maternal interactions, and the embryo is connected to these fetal membranes by the help of a cord of blood vessels. जिसको आप दिस क्या बोलते हैं लेटर ऑन विच इज कॉल्ड एज यूरेकस, ठीक है, और नेवल कॉर्ड जो लेटर ऑन वो डेवलप होती है, दैट इज द पॉइंट ऑफ एंट्री एंड एग्जिट ऑफ दिस प्लेसेंटा इनटू द एम्ब्रियो और यू कैन से फीटस, राइट। एंड एज द स्टेज ऑफ द प्रेगनेंसी एडवांसेस द साइज ऑफ द प्लेसेंटा इंक्रीजेस एंड becomes more and more functional, because the fetal body size increases, obviously the fetal needs, they increase, so the function of the placenta as well as the size, it increases as per the increasing demand of the fetus. So the maternal part of the placenta is called decidua, and the fetal placenta consists of different layers which include chorion, allantois, amnion, and the vestigial yolk sac. So chorion is the layer which is the outermost membrane covering the this fetus. It remains in direct contact with the maternal uterus. Okay, so allantois is the next layer to the inner side of the chorion, fine, and it has got allantoic cavity which is fluid filled, and the innermost layer is, or innermost membrane is, amnion, which is nearest to the fetus, and it is also a fluid filled cavity. Amniotic cavity is the cavity that contains, actually it contains the fetus. The fetus ke immediately around hoti hai cavity, that is amniotic cavity. It is fluid filled, amniotic fluid hota hai, and the membrane is called amnion. So at the time of parturition, two water bags come out along with the fetus. Jo allantoic cavity hai, it is called first water bag, because it comes earlier than the second one. Before the fetus comes out, exactly the allantoic cavity, which actually contains the waste of the body, it comes out, and second amniotic cavity or amniotic sac, it immediately covers the fetus. So when the fetus is delivered, it is delivered along with this amniotic sac. So this is called as second water bag. And this umbilical arteries and veins actually run through the connective tissue between the allantois and the chorion. So they are the major portals for exchange of nutrients, gases, as well as waste products from the body. So placenta is a very specialized structure, and its morphogenesis occurs during the early gestation. It is closely related to extra embryonic membranes or fetal membranes, जो हमने बात की अभी, जो differentiated है into amnion, allantoin, chorion and yolk sac. So depending upon the participation of these layers, क्योंकि हर तरह के placenta में हर layer involved नहीं होती है, अलग अलग species या अलग अलग species के हिसाब से, अलग अलग type of animals का हो या creatures के हिसाब से, अलग अलग layers involved होती हैं in the formation of this placenta. So depending upon the combination of layers involved, there are three basic types of placenta. One is chorionic type, one is chorioallantoic type, and another is yolk sac type. So in most of the almost all the farm animals, the placentation is of chorioallantoic type. उसमें कोरियन और एलेंटॉइस दोनों इन्वॉल्व होते हैं इन द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द प्लेसेंटा, राइट? सो दिस फीटोमैटरनल जंक्शंस आर हाईली इंक्रीज्ड एरिया. इसमें या तो कोरियोनिक विलाई बनते हैं जो यूट्रस की लेयर में क्रिप्ट्स हैं, मींस जैसे गड्ढे जैसे स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं, पिट लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स. तो ये कोरियोनिक विलाई दे प्रोट्रूड इनटू द यूट्राइन क्रिप्ट्स and form the fetomaternal junctions, or there is formation of chorionic labyrinths. ये जो एक आप structure देख रहे हैं, इसमें this portion, this is the maternal side of the placenta, this is the fetal side. See, these are villi-like structures and these pit-like structures on the uterine side or the dam side, these are called uterine crypts. और इन दोनों की एसोसिएशन को मिला के इट बिकम्स अ लेबिरिंथ. सो बेसिकली देयर आर सिक्स काइंड ऑफ टिश्यू लेयर्स व्हिच आर इन्वॉल्वड, और यू कैन से व्हिच आर मेजरली इन्वॉल्वड फॉर द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्लेसेंटा. उसमें से तीन लेयर्स आर फ्रॉम द मैटरनल साइड एंड थ्री लेयर्स आर फ्रॉम द फीटल साइड. ठीक है, तो जो मैटरनल साइड की लेयर्स हैं, दे आर uterine vascular endothelium, then uterine connective tissue, then uterine epithelium, and from the fetal side it is fetal trophoblast or allantochorionic epithelium and fetal connective tissue and then fetal capillary endothelium. ठीक है, so this is a pictorial you can say presentation of the different layers, six layers which are involved for the formation of the placenta. So इसमें से different type of placenta में different type of layers involved होती हैं, that I come to that point later on. So this is the capillary, so fetal endothelial cells, बीच में जो stroma है और connective tissue and the epithelial cell layer. ये आ गया fetal side का. So इसकी close opposition में on the opposite side is the endometrial epithelium, maternal connective tissue and maternal endothelial cells. Okay, so these epithelial cells ye direct exchange karenge aur yahan pe ye jo hai maternal blood and fetal blood ye aapas mein blood ka exchange hoga. So according to morphology, microscopic characteristics of fetal maternal barrier or the type of maternal tissue which is lost at the time of birth, क्योंकि जैसे ये एसोसिएशन बनी है, जब बर्थ होगा प्लेसेंटा विल कम आउट, उसके साथ कुछ ना कुछ मैटरनल टिश्यू भी लॉस होता है, क्योंकि एंडोमेट्रियम के साथ एसोसिएशन है क्लोज फीटल प्लेसेंटा की, फीटल साइड ऑफ प्लेसेंटा की. तो जब प्लेसेंटा शेड आउट होता है एट द टाइम ऑफ पार्चुरेशन और डिलीवरी और एट द टाइम ऑफ फीटल बर्थ, तो उस टाइम पे मैटरनल टिश्यू भी लॉस होता है. तो बेस्ड ऑन द स्ट्रक्चर्स इन्वॉल्व, प्लेसेंटा को हम क्लासिफाई करते हैं इनटू फाइव डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ प्लेसेंटल क्लासेस बेस्ड अपॉन द लेयर्स इन्वॉल्व. सो देयर आर फाइव क्लासेस. वन इज एपिथेलियो कोरियल, जिसमें एपिथेलियम और कोरियन इन्वॉल्व है, सिंडेस्मोकोरियल, एंडोथेलियो कोरियल, हिमोकोरियल एंड हिमो एंडोथेलियल. सो बेस्ड अपॉन द शेप ऑफ अटैचमेंट, क्योंकि जो अटैचमेंट है ऐसा नहीं है कि पूरे यूट्रस की पूरे प्लेसेंटा के साथ है, उसमें अलग अलग टाइप के स्ट्रक्चर्स हैं या अलग अलग शेप हैं ऑफ अटैचमेंट. आई हैव पिक्चर्स ऑफ दीज शेप ऑफ अटैचमेंट, सो इट विल बी क्लियर टू यू देन. सो वन इज डिफ्यूज टाइप, वन इज कॉटिलेडनरी टाइप. डिफ्यूज टाइप में क्या है, माइक्रो कॉटिलेडन्स होते हैं विच आर एक्चुअली स्प्रेड ओवर होल ऑफ द सर्फेस. So whole of the surface of placenta gets attached to whole of the surface of the uterus. लेकिन cotyledonary type में क्या है कि maternal caruncles होते हैं और fetal cotyledon बनते हैं, तो वो particular मिलके placentomes बनाते हैं. तो there are so many those kind of sites कहो या आप कहो attachment के points हैं. Cotyledons are the points of attachment of this fetal placenta along with the uterine endometrium. So cotyledonary type ho gaya ek. Another is zonary or discoid. Zonary mein kya hai ki it is a zone, band like structure jiski taraf se attachment hai, baki sab loose rehta hai. And discoid mein kya hai, there is one single attachment which is in the form of a disc like structure. The disc like structure gets attached to the uterine endometrium, और वो disc like structure जो है वो fetus से in the form of umbilical cord attached होता है. ठीक है, ये आगे different types. और this there are different species, इनमें different species में ये सब present होते हैं. तो you have seen these six layers of cells which in combination form the different types of placenta. So when we talk about this epithelio-corial type of placenta, it involves all the six layers of different cells. Syndesmocorial mein there are five layers involved. Endothelio-corial mein there are four layers involved. Hemocorial mein there are just three layers. Or hemoendothelial mein there is just one layer. Okay. So these are the species in the different type ke placenta present hai. Epithelio-corial kaho based on placental class or shape of attachment. Diffuse type jo hai, it is present in pigs, horses, donkeys. So jo ye cotyledonary type hai, ye sheep goat mein hai aur yahan pe cattle bhi aana chahiye saath mein. Cattle and buffalo. Okay. और जो ये जोनरी है, जोनरी टाइप, इट इज प्रेजेंट इन डॉग्स, कैट्स, फेरेट्स. डिस्कॉइड टाइप जो है ये प्राइमेट्स में, जैसे मंकीज हैं, ह्यूमंस हैं, इनमें प्रेजेंट होता है. और दिस हेमो एंडोथेलियल टाइप जो है ये रैट में, रैबिट में, गिनी पिग वगैरह में प्रेजेंट है. ठीक है, सो बेस्ड ऑन प्लेसेंटल शेप एंड कॉन्टैक्ट पॉइंट्स व्हिच वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अर्लियर. So it looks like this. The diffused hai, the whole of the surface of placenta gets attached to the surface of the uterus, or you can say endometrium of the uterus. So it is diffused type. Jo multicotyledonary hai, isme ye hai, jo point of attachments hai, they are the cotyledons, or you can say placentomes. Zonary type mein, jaise fetus hai, fetal layers hai, ye sirf ek zone or band like structure hai which will be attached to the surface of the uterus. On discoid mein only there is a disc like structure which gets attached to the surface of the uterus. So let's discuss these four types of placenta one by one. So this diffuse type of placenta, in this type of placenta, almost the entire surface of allantochorion, it is involved in the formation of the placenta. This is a picture of diffuse type of placenta from sow. So, आप देख सकते हो ये पूरा का पूरा red है. So, जितना भी part reddish है, this whole surface will be attached to the endometrium. So, this kind of placenta is present in horses and pigs. So next is cotyledonary type. These are the cotyledons. Cotyledons are of two types. One is convex dome shape, one is crypt like or pit like concave shape. So cattle and buffalo mein convex type present hoga or this ewe and doe, matlab sheep and goat mein concave type present hai. And the number varies according to the species involved. So cotyledon mein kya hai, there are multiple discrete areas of attachment which are called as fetal cotyledons. They form interaction patches of allantochorion along with the endometrium. So jo ye cotyledons wale part hai, only these particular portions or parts will be attached to the endometrium, rest all will be free. So fetal portion of this cotyledonary placenta is called cotyledon, fetal cotyledons, or jo maternal contact site hai that is called as maternal caruncle, and together they form complex structure which is called placentome. Placentome is the functional unit of the cotyledonary type of placenta. So it is present in all the ruminants, which includes sheep, goat, cattle, buffalo. So next is zonary type. In this type of placenta, there is complete or incomplete band-like structure around band-like tissue structure around the fetus, which gets joined to with the endometrium of the uterus. So it is present in dogs, cats, seals, bears, and elephants as well. So this is the fetus. Ye umbilical cord hai, dheere dheere ye attach hua, it is surrounded by whole of the placenta, but this band like structure which you can see marginated as black and बीच में जो बैंड है इट इज रेडिश इन कलर. सो दिस इज जोनरी टाइप ऑफ प्लेसेंटल अटैचमेंट. सो नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू द डिस्कॉइड टाइप, दिस इज अ सिंगल प्लेसेंटा एंड इज फॉर्म्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ डिस्क. जैसे ये पूरी प्लेसेंटल लेयर है, बट इट इज अ डिस्क लाइक स्ट्रक्चर विच इज अटैच टू द यूट्रस एंड दिस इज अम्बिलिकल कॉर्ड which will go in towards the fetus, and this cord like structure will be attached to the fetus. So it is present in case of primates as well as rodents. So next coming to the type of placentas based upon different tissue layers involved. So first is epitheliochorial placenta. In this particular type of placenta, it has got all the six layers involved. जैसे हमने जो पढ़ी थी अभी, fetal endothelium, then stroma or connective tissue, and third layer was superficial epithelium from the fetal side, and then from uterine side it was uterine endo this epithelium, then stroma or connective tissue, and this endothelium. तो इसमें छह की छह लेयर्स इन्वॉल्व हैं एपिथेलियोकोरियल टाइप ऑफ प्लेसेंटा में. तो दिस टाइप ऑफ प्लेसेंटा इज प्रेजेंट इन हॉर्सेस एज वेल एज डंकीज. सो इट इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड बाय डेवलपमेंट ऑफ एंडोमेट्रियल कप्स. सी दिस इज द एंडोमेट्रियम, दीज आर एंडोमेट्रियल कप्स जिसमें माइक्रो कॉटिलेडन्स फ्रॉम द फीटल साइड दे गेट अटैच्ड. ये इस तरह से ये पूरा जंक्शन बनता है इसका, ठीक है, ये माइक्रो कॉटिलेडनरी हो गया. ओके, तो दीज कप्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन सेमी सर्कुलर एरिया. जैसे आप ये देख सकते हो, दिस इज सेमी सर्कुलर एरिया आधा है, और इट डेवलप्स बिटवीन 6 टू 20th वीक ऑफ जेस्टेशन, राइट. तो नेक्स्ट कम्स सिनडेस्मोकोरियल प्लेसेंटा. इसमें क्या है, यूट्राइन एपिथीलियम डिसअपियर्स in the restricted areas which are called placentomes due to invasive action of trophoblast. Trophoblast layer is the outermost layer of the fetus. Jo jaise jab ye kya bolte hain fetus this elongation hoti hai, trophoblast elongation hoti hai, uske baad mein it invades the uterine layer, aur is case mein uterine epithelium present nahi hogi, it will be lost. Only five structures are there. Only rest of the five tissue layers are involved in the formation of syndesmochorial type of placenta. So the fetal structures formed are called placentomes. These are the placentomes, right? And this is the fetus. It is surrounded by amnion layer, and this is called amniotic sac. And the fluid present is called amniotic fluid. So this is present in case of cattle, buffalo, sheep, and goat. So the next is endotheliochorial placenta. इसमें क्या है, मेटरनल कनेक्टिव टिश्यू इज ऑल्सो लॉस्ट, एपिथीलियम इज लॉस्ट, कनेक्टिव टिश्यू इज लॉस्ट, एंड द एलेंटोकोरियोनिक एपिथीलियम इज इन अपोजिशन टू द एंडोथेलियम ऑफ द मेटरनल वेसल्स. अपर टू लेयर्स आर लॉस्ट, सो इट विल बी कंप्राइजिंग ऑफ फोर सेल लेयर्स, थ्री फ्रॉम द फीटल साइड एंड फ्रॉम द मेटरनल साइड देयर विल बी ओनली वन लेयर व्हिच इज एंडोथेलियम वाली. So gross shape of this kind of placenta is either zonary or discoid, and it is present in dogs, cats, and ferrets. So this is the fetus surrounded by fetal membranes, and this is the zonary type of placenta. जिसमें margins जो हैं, they are greenish black, and the central portion is pink or reddish in color. Next comes the hemochorial type. It is formed in case of primates. इसमें क्या है, मैटरनल टिश्यू का पूरा लॉस हो जाता है, एंडोथेलियम विल आल्सो बी लॉस्ट, एंड इट इज मोस्ट एडवांस्ड एंड एवोल्यूशनरी टाइप ऑफ प्लेसेंटा एज द ट्रांसफर ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स इज द मोस्ट रैपिड. इसमें क्या है, दिस मैटरनल टिश्यू इज लॉस्ट, तो डायरेक्टली जो है इसको हम इन्वेसिव टाइप ऑफ दिस प्लेसेंटा भी बोलते हैं. दिस इज इन्वेसिव टाइप ऑफ प्लेसेंटा. इसमें क्या है, प्लेसेंटल कनेक्शन जो है ये डायरेक्टली मेटरनल ब्लड के साथ होता है. तो ऑब्वियसली जब डायरेक्टली ब्लड के साथ कनेक्शन है तो जो भी एक्सचेंज है ऑफ न्यूट्रिएंट्स का हो, गैसेस का हो, दैट विल बी मोस्ट रैपिड. ठीक है, सो वी कैन से दैट फीटल प्लेसेंटा बेथ्स डायरेक्टली इनटू द ब्लड पूल ऑफ मदर्स यूट्रस, इसीलिए इसको हम हेमोकोरियल बोलते हैं. ये हेमो जो पार्ट है इट कम्स फ्रॉम ब्लड. सो द नेक्स्ट इज हेमो एंडोथेलियल टाइप. इसमें क्या है, इट कंप्राइजेस ऑफ फीटल एंडोथेलियम ओनली, सिर्फ फीटल एंडोथेलियम इज डायरेक्टली इन कंटैक्ट विद द मैटरनल ब्लड. So it is present in case of rats, rabbits, and guinea pig. So this is all about various types of placenta based on their different type of tissue layers involved, or the type of structures, or the type of attachment form, shape of the attachment of placenta with the uterine endometrium. So next coming to functions of the placenta. So there are various functions which are performed by this placenta for the fetal survival. Which involves nutrient supply, gaseous supply, as well as disposal of the waste materials. So placenta performs many functions, and it substitutes for all kinds of organ systems of the fetus. It acts as gastrointestinal tract as well, because it helps in nutrient digestion, nutrient exchange. Then because it is responsible for gaseous exchange, so it acts as lungs. So as it acts as disposal of the waste product, so acts as kidneys as well. Then detoxification or any kind of metabolism, so it functions as liver as well, and the endocrine glands, because there are balance of hormones as well. It maintains the balance of hormones between the fetus and the maternal side. So the placenta it separates the maternal and fetal organisms. Thus, it ensures that there is separate development of the fetus inside the mother's womb, or you can say dam's womb. So, blood of the fetus and dam, they never come in direct contact. They are two different types of circulations, but they are close enough, but they have just enough junctions between the chorion of the fetus and the endometrium of the mother for oxygen, nutrients to pass between the two bodies, and this oxygen and nutrients are carried from the maternal body towards the fetal body, and the waste products from the fetal body, they are carried out in the opposite direction, that is from fetus side to the maternal side. So the first function is exchange of gases. So exchange of gases across the placenta, it's very much similar that how it happens across the lungs in any individual. But the major difference between the two exchange systems, means placenta and lungs, is jo placenta mein exchange system hai, it is fluid to fluid, means from one blood type to another blood type. But in case of lungs, they have gas to fluid system. Air is inhaled and then it gets exchanged in via our lungs into the body via blood. Also, the umbilical arteries, they carry unoxygenated blood from the fetus to the placenta. Normally jo hai arteries, they carry oxygenated blood. So there are few exceptions, and umbilical artery is one of those. It carries unoxygenated blood from the fetus towards the dam, and the umbilical veins, they carry oxygenated blood in the reverse direction. That means from the dam's blood, from the dam towards the fetus. So this is one exception of जो normally arteries का function है to carry oxygenated blood, and veins का है to carry the deoxygenated blood. But here it is the opposite. So fetal blood has a low affinity for carbon dioxide from fetal to maternal blood. So that's why this counter current exchange happens, and it happens on the basis of actually this concentration gradient. जहाँ पे concentration gradient ज़्यादा है, जहाँ पे कम है, तो ज़्यादा वाली से कम वाली के towards ये flow करता है. So next function is transport of nutrients. So various nutrients which include sugars, amino acids, vitamins, minerals, all these are transported from the dam's body towards the fetus, which are very important for fetal growth inside the womb. So once this session ends, we will start another session with the same idea and password. So next is transport of nutrients is based on net flux from the dam to fetus, or in the opposite direction. Like I told you just now, that there is concentration difference, because in the maternal blood there will be high concentration of all these nutrients, and in the fetal blood it will be lesser. So from higher concentration gradient towards lower concentration gradient it happens. So next is this glucose, amino acids, electrolytes and vitamins, they are transported by carrier system, which is located in the trophoblast of the fetal side. So placenta contains large amounts of glycogen, but which is mainly synthesized from the maternal glucose. And in the fetal blood, fructose is 70-80% of the sugar. Fructose forms. Otherwise, normally जो होती है वो क्या होती है? This is glucose. नॉर्मली जो एक इंडिविजुअल में होता है, इट इज मेनली ग्लूकोज. सो प्रोटीन्स एज सच, बिकॉज दे आर लार्जर इन साइज, दे आर नॉट एज सच ट्रांसफर्ड डायरेक्टली, बट दे आर अमाइनो एसिड्स ट्रांसफर होते हैं एंड देन प्रोटीन्स आर फॉर्म्ड इन द फीटल बॉडी. तो अमाइनो एसिड्स क्रॉस रेडिली अगेंस्ट अ कंसंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट ऑब्वियसली एंड आर फाउंड इन हायर कंसंट्रेशन इन फीटस देन इन मैमिलियन प्लाज्मा. क्योंकि वो डायरेक्टली अमाइनो एसिड्स का ट्रांसफर हो रहा है इसीलिए इसकी कंसंट्रेशन फीटस में ज्यादा होती है एज कंपेयर टू मैमिलियन प्लाज्मा. और इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन सभी स्पीशीज में नहीं ट्रांसफर होते हैं अक्रॉस द फीटा दिस प्लेसेंटा बट इम्यूनोग्लोबुलिन आर ट्रांसफर्ड इन ह्यूमंस एंड